In this video, we'll discuss carcinoma of the thyroid gland. Thyroid cancer are the most common malignancy of the endocrine system. It occurs in 10 per 100,000 per year. Male-female ratio is 1:2, but the men have a worse prognosis. What's the age incidence for thyroid cancer? It comes in youngs and olds, younger than 20 and older than 50 years of age. How about the radioactive iodine uptake? Which type of cancers take radioactive iodine? Medullary thyroid carcinoma does not take radioactive iodine. Anaplastic thyroid carcinoma takes negligible radioactive iodine. Follicular and papillary thyroid carcinoma take radioactive iodine but less than normal thyroid tissue. Loss of iodine uptake inversely correlate with survival. 5 to 15% of patients with thyroid cancer become refractory to radioactive iodine, and medium survival for radioactive iodine refractory patient is 3 years. What are the defects in thyroid cancers? Apart from increased growth and loss of function, there is decreased iodine uptake due to decreased sodium iodide symporter activity, decreased iodine organification, and decreased radioactive iodine uptake. How thyroid staging is done? It's done with TNM classification, and there are 4 stages based on tumor size, local invasion, and distant metastasis. What are the tumor stages? Depending on the size. Stage 1, tumor size 1 to 2 cm, and this is a low risk group. Stage 2, tumor size 2 to 4 cm. Stage 3, regardless of tumor size, with local metastasis. And stage 4, tumor size more than 4 cm with distant metastasis. What are the features of stage 4 cancers? They are more than 4 cm. All anaplastic thyroid cancers are stage 4. All undifferentiated cancers are stage 4. All cancers with distant metastasis are stage 4, and they have poor prognosis. What's the difference between well-differentiated and undifferentiated tumors? The well-differentiated tumors are treatable with good prognosis. Undifferentiated carcinomas are aggressive and have bleak prognosis. What's the most common thyroid cancer? Papillary thyroid carcinoma occurs in 80 to 90% of cases. What's the most common endocrine cancer? Papillary thyroid carcinoma. What tumor develops in diffuse non-toxic goiter? Follicular thyroid carcinoma. What tumor develops in solitary cold nodule? Follicular thyroid cancer. Which tumor produces calcitonin? Medullary thyroid carcinoma. Which tumor has rapidly enlarging thyroid? Lymphoma. What are the serum markers of thyroid cancers and what do they do? Serum markers detect residual or recurrent disease, and they are thyroglobulin for papillary thyroid carcinoma and follicular thyroid carcinoma, and calcitonin for medullary thyroid carcinoma. Main role of thyroglobulin measurement is in follow-up of thyroid cancer treatment after thyroidectomy or radioablation. Globulin levels should be undetectable. Variable levels indicate incomplete ablation or recurrent. What's the pathogenesis of thyroid cancer? Thyroid cancers are monoclonal in origin, that is, mutation starts in a single cell, and some cancer exhibit impaired apoptosis and other features. What are the disadvantages of impaired apoptosis? Disadvantages of impaired apoptosis are enhanced invasion, angiogenesis, and metastasis. Radiation exposure increases the risk of benign and malignant thyroid nodules. Head and neck radiation in children especially increases the risk. What radiation exposure causes to increase the thyroid cancer? External radiation predisposes to chromosomal break, and that chromosomal break leads to loss of tumor suppressor gene. Loss of heterogeneity consistent with deletion of tumor suppressor gene is common in follicular thyroid carcinoma. What's the effect of iodine-131 therapy? Iodine-131 therapy causes minimal increase of thyroid cancer. What's the TSH role in thyroid cancer? Many differentiated thyroid cancer remains responsive to TSH because they have TSH receptor. So TSH increases the activity and growth of a tumor. What are different types of thyroid cancer? Papillary thyroid carcinoma, follicular thyroid carcinoma, medullary thyroid carcinoma, and anaplastic thyroid carcinoma. The papillary thyroid carcinoma is the most common endocrine tumor, occurring in 80 to 90% of cases. What are the characteristic cytological features of papillary thyroid carcinoma on FNA biopsy? Somoma body. Somoma body is a dystrophic calcified cell with cleaved nuclei with an empty or ground glass or often any appearance of large nucleoli. There are formation of papillary structures. Papillary carcinoma spreads locally, number 2 through lymph node, and number 3 hematogenously. Most papillary thyroid carcinoma are identified in the early stages and have excellent prognosis compared to the follicular thyroid carcinoma, which is not identified early, which is identified late in the disease and has a bad prognosis. Mortality with papillary thyroid carcinoma is increased markedly in stage 4. Follicular thyroid carcinoma is more common in iodine deficient areas and frequently presents as solitary cold nodules. Distinction between benign and malignant form, the follicular adenoma and carcinoma, is difficult by FNA biopsy. Cytology does not differentiate between benign and malignant tumors. So how they are distinguished? Distinction between benign and malignant form is done by evidence of invasion into vessels, nerves, or adjacent structure. The follicular tumor is spread by hematogenous route to bone, lungs, and CNS, unlike the papillary tumors, which is spread locally and lymph nodes also. Large proportion of patients present with a stage 4 disease in follicular thyroid carcinoma. That's why prognosis is bad. What are the bad prognostic features? Primary tumor size more than 4 cm, age more than 50, distant metastasis, and vascular invasion. Anaplastic cancer. Anaplastic cancer are stage 4. Poorly differentiated. Aggressive cancer, prognosis is poor. Most patients die in 6 months and it usually occurs in elderly women. And how about radioiodine uptake in anaplastic cancer? Because of undifferentiated state, radioiodine uptake is negligible in anaplastic cancer. The medullary carcinoma of the thyroid. Medullary carcinoma produces calcitonin that decreases the serum calcium. How about radioiodine uptake? Does not take radioactive iodine. It accounts for 5-10% of thyroid cancer and develops in parafollicular or C type of cell. It may be sporadic, familial, and is a part of multiple endocrine neoplasm type 2 and type 1. Management is primarily surgical, and for advanced cases, external radiation. Thyroid lymphoma. Thyroid lymphoma often arises in Hashimoto's thyroiditis. They have a rapidly expanding thyroid mass. And on biopsy in thyroid lymphoma, sheets of lymphoid cells that are difficult to distinguish from a small cell lung cancer or anaplastic thyroid carcinoma. They are highly sensitive to external radiation. Why surgical resection should be avoided initially? Thyroid lymphoma, surgical resection should be avoided initially because it may spread the localized tumors. What's the TSH role in thyroid cancer? Many differentiated thyroid cancer remains responsive to TSH because they have TSH receptor. So TSH increases the activity and growth of a tumor. Treatment of thyroid cancer depends on the type of the cells in a thyroid cancer. The treatment is done with TSH suppression therapy, radioactive iodine treatment, surgery, and the drug treatment. Why thyroid hormones are used to treat thyroid cancer? Thyroid hormones are used to suppress TSH because TSH causes increased activity of the thyroid cancer and increased growth. Treatment with thyroid hormone decreases tumor growth and mass. Tumor suppression with levothyroxine decreases the size of the nodule by about 30% and prevents further growth. TSH suppression is done by levothyroxine is the mainstay of treatment, but the side effects of levothyroxine are atrial fibrillation, osteopenia, and anxiety. How much TSH should be suppressed? For low risk group, TSH should be suppressed partially. So partial suppression of TSH for low risk group, and for high risk group, complete suppression of TSH should be done. Unbound T4 is monitored to avoid excessive treatment. Radioiodine treatment is done for well-differentiated thyroid cancer. They incorporate radioiodine, though less than normal thyroid tissue. Radioactive iodine therapy is done for papillary thyroid carcinoma, follicular thyroid carcinoma, and for Hurtle cell carcinoma. It's not done for medullary thyroid carcinoma and anaplastic thyroid carcinoma because they don't take radioactive iodine. Surgery. Surgery is done for well-differentiated papillary, follicular, and medullary thyroid carcinoma. It may be done with lobectomy for the small tumor. Advantage with lobectomy is that it doesn't cause damage to the recurrent laryngeal nerve and hypothyroidism. For bigger tumors, near total thyroidectomy or thyroid aberration with removal of involved lymph nodes. In case of extensive neck dissection, sternocleidomastoid and accessory nerves should be preserved. Radioactive iodine treatment also done postoperatively in papillary, follicular and Hertel cell carcinoma because these tumors take radioactive iodine, though less than normal thyroid. Why iodine-131 treatment is done after thyroidectomy? Iodine-131 treatment is done after thyroidectomy to treat residual tumor cells because thyroid tissues remain in the thyroid bed and surrounding the parathyroid gland. What's the follow-up of thyroid treatment? Whole body scan 6 months after thyroid ablation. How TSH is increased after treatment? Switch the patient from levothyroxine T4 to T3 levothyroxine, which is more rapidly cleared. When the TSH is increased, it will increase production of thyroglobulin. Any increase in thyroglobulin indicates that the thyroid cancer has a recurrence or was not removed completely. Ideally, thyroglobulin level should be undetectable after TSH increase. After thyroidectomy, thyroid hormones are given for whole life. Treatment for undifferentiated thyroid cancers, anaplastic cancers and with metastasis. Radiation therapy. External beam radiation therapy, EBRT, is done for stage 4 disease, tumor growth at distant metastasis and when a large unresectable tumor is present and when radioiodine uptake is limited. Treatment for thyroid lymphoma, as we already discussed in lymphoma, they are highly sensitive to external radiation and their surgical resection should be avoided initially because it may spread the localized tumor. Treatment for medullary thyroid carcinoma is primarily by surgical and for advanced cases, external radiation and chemotherapy.